First of all, I would like to thank the organizers and Alejandro in particular for this opportunity to participate in the webinar and share ideas with people from other countries. It is very stimulating. And in my 10-minute presentation, I will share some information from the Italian side. Next slide, please. I introduce this presentation with some data on aquaculture production in Italy. From the analysis of 2017 data, Italy has a total production of about 180,000 tons. It is sixth in Europe after Norway, Spain, Turkey, UK, and France. In percentage, Italian aquaculture represents about 11%, both in terms of production and economic value. And about 75% of this production is attributable to marine species, and in particular to only four species, such as clams, mussels, sea bass, and sea bream. Next, please. Most of the production is based on mollusks, followed by fish, and only a very small proportion is represented by crustaceans. Analyzing only fish, the marine production is about 15,000 tons. The farms of marine species are mainly located in the northern part of the country. Important are also some regions such as Sardinia and Apulia in the south. Next, please. Regarding the development of aquaculture in Italy, the overall objective is in line with those of a common fisheries policy, which specifically refer to an increase in production, a reduction of the dependency on imported seafood, and also the fostering of coastal and rural areas. In more detail, specific objectives are set by the National Strategic Plan for Aquaculture, and production is intended to be increased by 35% compared to 2013 by 2025. The strategic plan also identifies the points that need attention in order to achieve these goals, which are the diversification of processes and products, also the modernization and expansion of existing facilities, the construction of new ones, and the improvement in the use of marine space with the identification of new areas allocated for aquaculture. From this point, the need to include aquaculture among one of the primary activity in the marine spatial planning process is clear. Next, please. The Maritime Spatial Planning Directive has been implemented in Italy by a legislative decree in 2016. The Ministry of Infrastructure and Transport was appointed as the competent authority responsible for the implementation of the strategy. An interministerial coordination committee was also created in order to harmonize the different national interests, and it includes representatives from different ministries. Moreover, a technical committee was created in order to draw up a management plan. However, so far, marine spatial planning in Italy is still at an early stage of development, of implementation, with a geographical imbalance in the progress of the process, as so far actions have focused almost exclusively on the Adriatic area. Next, please. Nevertheless, the adoption of marine spatial planning for aquaculture is a priority in Italy because of several reasons, such as the above mentioned ambitious growth objectives, the lack of terrestrial coastal areas suitable due to larger urban development restrictions, protection measures and so on. Also social issues. There is an increasing concern because of the negative image of both aquaculture production and products. There is an increasing competition for space and conflicts with other uses. Many actors are involved. There is the need for equity for aquaculture, the aquaculture sector, which is so far a smaller player within marine spatial planning. Environmental issues are also inherent degradation of marine environments because conflicts with environmental conservations, marine protected areas, 2000 nature sites, and so on. There is also a reduction in financial resources available. And last but not least, there are governance issues. Because of the overcomplicated governance and often inefficient planning process, and above all, poor licensing procedures. Next, please. In consideration of this last point, a great concern is on the complex administrative framework for aquaculture. Regions indeed have the legislative power regarding aquaculture activities, but at the national level, many ministries have different competencies. As an example, the Ministry of Infrastructures and Transport is responsible for marine spatial planning and licensing for aquaculture activities, while the Ministry of Agriculture, Food and Forestry Policies is responsible for the national policy in aquaculture and so on. So there are many reference authorities to interface with, and the need for a reorganization and above all, a better coordination of governance is a priority. Next, please. The establishment of allocated zones for aquaculture, AZAs, is a priority in Italy for national aquaculture development. AZAs are marine areas where aquaculture is a priority over other activities. Indeed, for the expansion development of the sector, the availability of space is a key factor. There are complex interactions among among different users in coastal areas, and this often leaves little space for aquaculture, particularly since mariculture requires high quality seawater and high quality environment. The AZA establishment process also meets the features of marine spatial planning, as it is adaptive, it is participatory, future oriented, and also ecosystem based, because it is built on the ecosystem approach to aquaculture and also on integrated coastal zone management. Next, please. There are several regions where the establishment of AZAs is at an advanced stage in Italy, such as Latium, Campania, also Tuscany. And also in the Adriatic area, the planning of maritime activities and aquaculture has been integrated with other coastal uses. However, in this presentation, I will show an emblematic case study regarding the region of Sicily, the region where I work, because Sicily has played in the past an important role in the national context of aquaculture. Till the mid-20s, the production represented up to 20% of that of the entire country, with about 20 farms. While currently there are only 5 farms for marine species and also 2 hatcheries, accounting totally for less than 10% of the national production. The cause of this decline can be traced back to the general economic crisis of the 20s, at the end of the 20s, and to the fact that small companies were not in a position to deal with it. In many cases, indeed, the running costs are difficult to afford for small companies. However, Sicily is very interested in the expansion and recovery of the sector, and it has a great potential for mariculture with a coastline longer than 1,500 kilometers. Next, please. Well, in the Italian context, Sicily has been a pioneer region. Since in the mid-20s, it developed guidelines for the installation of new facilities, which were then implemented by a regional decree in 2009. And these guidelines are still in force. The guidelines are based on an early AZA approach. So they allowed the identification of suitable areas for aquaculture. And the guidelines established a three-stage process. The process is described in this slide. There is an initial project, initial proposal, which in the event of a positive evaluation is followed by a detailed project. This, in case of a final approval, allows the installation of the facility, which is then subjected to environmental monitoring. The guidelines overall simplified the complex administrative process and made the roles of various parts much clearer than before. Next, please. Also, very important that the guidelines set all the details for each of the three-phase process. One of the most complex stages is the selection of site, and the guidelines identifies four categories of use of the marine space depending on environmental vulnerability, carrying capacity of the site, and also provide detailed indications on how to select a proper site for mariculture, listing a detailed list of the environmental variables to take into account, and also provide indications on how to limit conflicts with other uses. Basically, this planning identified areas where mariculture can be carried out, other sites where it can be implemented with restrictions in biomass, and also sites where it is not allowed. Next, please. Also, the guidelines detailed very well the monitoring plan after the establishment of marine farms. As indicated in this slide, there are specific design for the sampling campaign, and also a very detailed list on the environmental variables to be analyzed, and the periods, the sites, and so on. Next, please. Finally, and specifically in the context of marine spatial planning, I would like to emphasize the poor consideration of aquaculture in marine spatial planning to date. Although there are some regional examples, there is a lot of work to do. And as far as recommendations, I have here listed a few of them, which include the establishment of allocated zones for aquaculture according to the principles of the ecosystem approach, the minimization of conflicts, above all with fisheries, environmental conservation, land sea interactions, and also the reduction of environmental impacts. Some solutions can be integrated multitrophic aquaculture, as I discussed before, but also the movement of aquaculture facilities towards the offshore, where conflicts are reduced. There is a higher social acceptability of these infrastructures, and also where the facilities can operate within appropriate environmental conditions. Also, it is important to identify and to foster the positive interactions with other marine space uses, such as wind and wave energy farms, as an example, but also tourism has a great potential. Social acceptability must be improved. And for this reason, offshore aquaculture can be a good solution. There is the need to a good integration with the objectives of the Marine Strategy Framework Directive. And again, last but not least, it is very important to focus on the simplification of rules for licensing, for monitoring, and above all, a better coordination of central, regional, but also local administrations. Finally, the key point is not to transform the process of spatial planning of mariculture activities into a penalization for the sector by simply indicating spatial restrictions that risk to slow down the recovery of the sector. It is important the involvement of stakeholders, of the operators of the sector, to transform the spatial planning into an opportunity that, together with other measures and with incentives, can represent a real opportunity for the development of mariculture in Italy, but also overall in the Mediterranean basin. I thank you for your attention, and I hope to have given some insight to be discussed further this afternoon. Thank you.